White supremacy is hilarious to me. It makes no sense. It's stupid. I remember like when all the Confederate flag thing was going down. Like you see all the Confederate flag was coming down, and you see all those white supremacists on TV like, "Hey man, it's our pride, it's our history, man, and I'm just mad. I'm just mad, God darn it, it's coming down. I am upset." And I'm like, dude, don't be mad because they're taking your flag down. Don't be mad. You should be mad that your great-great-grandfather didn't fight as hard. That is why you should be mad. You lost, bitch. No, you don't. We don't hang losers' flags up. You don't see any Utah Jazz flags in here, do you? No, you don't. You don't. You don't see any British flags up in here, do you? They're losers. They lost. Man, fuck British people, man. Are any British people in here? Are any British people? Okay, fuck you, okay? I'm gonna talk shit about you. I think British people get a pass because they sound funny when they talk. It's like, I'm from England. I'm called cigarette spags and I'm amazing. Like, no, you're a horrible person historically. If you think about it, British people are the reason why most of the world celebrate Independence Day. Think about that. They're horrible people. They're worse than Nazis. And they complain about immigrants coming to their country like, no, we need to get rid of these Africans and these Asians. Like, no, fuck you, British people. And if you don't want to know, you want to know how bad British people, you want to know how bad a British person is, just ask a Native American person, okay? You probably don't know any Native American people thanks to fucking British people and their shitty blankets, okay? So if you see a British person, punch him in the face and say, tell him I sent you. I bring this up because I had an interaction with this British dude and he was getting on my nerves. And he kept bothering me all night. And I was like, dude, okay, what's going on, man? He's like, hey, mate, what's going on, mate? What you do? What you do, mate? I'm like, dude, I'm a comedian. He's like, all right, I love comedy. How can I come see you? And I was like, well, you can go to my website. You can put your email on my email listing. He's like, oh, man, that sounds great, but I don't want to give you my email. And I was like, why don't you want to give me your email? He says, because my email is a little tricky, and I'm a little embarrassed by it, mate. And I was like, okay, dude, whatever, man. Just get out of my face, whatever. He's like, all right, mate, I'll give it to you, but you can't judge me. And I was like, dude, I won't judge you. And now I have to figure out what's his email. I need to know. So he writes his email down, and he hands it to me, and I take it, and I looked at his email, and I read it. His email was, ihateniggers@aol.com. That was his email address that he gave to me. And I was like, what the fuck is wrong with you, mate? He said, hey, mate, I told you it was a little tricky, and I was a little embarrassed, mate, and I know that things have changed in the years 2015, and I know I should still not have an America Online account. And I was like, oh, ha ha, you cheeky bastard, you. I see what you did there, sir. And I'm, sir, a fan of comedy, and I'm a fan of that, and I appreciate what you just did. And I laughed, and we had a moment, and we became best friends. And I know he wasn't serious, ladies and gentlemen, because he ended up buying me drinks all night, and he didn't even try to have sex with me. He didn't. But if he did try to have sex with me, I wouldn't have had sex with him, but I definitely would have gave him a hand job. Because like I said, he bought me drinks all night. Ladies, pay attention.